live stream video, and today we're gonna I think the sound is working. We're gonna do the apostolic word for July. I tried to do it two or three times, and somehow I did an upgrade, which was a new software, and there was no sound on YouTube or whatever, so I had to go back to my old standby. So if you don't see in how the stuff I usually have on there, it'll be alright. As long as you hear the word, you're good to go. Apostolic word for July, and what I like to say is that being believers in Christ, you got to know the difference in the different types of words God released. I didn't say prophetic word because it's not a prophetic word. A prophetic word is something that points you to a direction or to a place to get what you need. An apostolic word is more of a word of alignment or a word of understanding or a word of basically getting your life in order. So he gave me three things the other day. I did a Periscope video, but like I said, I was kind of in a rush because I was on the way to an appointment. So, you know, a lot of times as leaders, you got to learn not to rush the revelation, because I really felt I didn't give it the totality of what God had spoke to me. So what is the apostolic word for July? It's three words: detox, detach, and distance. We have to understand that we're not getting any younger, we're getting older. And a lot of the things that we do and what we put up with or what we do, we're taking the grace of God for granted. And when you take the grace of God for granted, then sometimes he has to show you that he means business, if that sounds correct to some of you. With all this, God is love and God is good. God also punishes those who do wrong. We have to understand that. So what is the detox? See, we have you need to detox in three different ways. You need to detox spiritually, mentally, and naturally. What is detox? Detox is a process or period in which one abstains from or rids the body of toxic or unhealthy substances. So what God was speaking is, spiritually, a lot of you are in ministry that is toxic to your growth, is toxic to your understanding, it toxic to your relationship, it's toxic to your finance, it's also toxic to the anointing and destiny God has over your life. How is it toxic? Because many of you are in ministries that's not fulfilling the call of God on your life, is actually draining the call of God on your life. So God wants you to spiritually take an evaluation of where you are, the people you listen to, and the places you go. If there's anything that's detrimental to your growth in God, you got to leave them alone. See, a lot of you have got comfortable because you got people preaching something called keep it real. He didn't tell us to preach a keep it real gospel. He told us to preach the truth. See, just because it's real don't mean it's the truth. A lot of people say things that have fleshly and carnal overtone, and y'all be hooping and hollering, ooh, say it, yeah, that's right. But spiritually, it does you no good. It doesn't rid the body of those toxic things that you in. Mentally, detoxification. Some of you have sat on these people spiritually for so long that mentally that you can't listen to nobody else. If they ain't in your circle, you don't want to hear nothing they got to say unless you want them to give you a donation. You want them to give you a seed. But you're not giving them nothing for God to look forward to in them. So we got a lot of people that using the gospel to merely pimp people and keep them in bondage. You got to understand that if you're going to come out, I'm just looking at something, and somebody sent me something. And you got to realize that if you're going to grow in God, you need people around you who's going to take you to the next level with the truth. It ain't got to always be about money, but people made it all about money. Natural detox is the next thing we're getting at. God wants you to detox naturally. A lot of us don't understand that the food that most of us eat is toxic to our body. You know, you got all that stuff just sitting in your stomach that been in there for 4, 5, 6 years, all that compacted defecation and colon there. God, when is the last time have you ever cleaned your body out? You have to start researching and learn that a lot of these foods that we are digesting and taking to our body is not being grown or is not at the level where God intended. See, God said everything we eat should have a seed after its own kind. Ain't no way in the world you can't have an organic, seedless watermelon. Because, watch this, because in order to get another watermelon, you have to have a seed in it. In order to get another grape, it got to be a seed in it. In order to get another, they make seed, watch this, your mind got to click. Well, how is you going to get some more if there ain't no seed in it? This seedless stuff is not of God, because according to scripture, it has to have a seed after its own kind. Then we look at all the antibiotics and all the stuff that they give and feed the animals. And we take this in our body. So when you go to the doctor, if you're sick and they give you this medicine, the reason that the medicine really don't partake on you is because it's already in the food you eat. So therefore, it's of no effect. You already immune to it. You gotta look at it. You can't be eating all this pork. You look up that video and learn about pork worms, and when you eat and digest that pork and that bacon, and it showed that video of how the pork worms be eating up your mind and all that kind of stuff. I love steaks. Y'all, you see me and the wife and the family, we always at Longhorn eating them big old steaks. I'm talking about, I get the big part of the house, the biggest one they got. But the Lord spoke to me. Cut all that out. That's why y'all don't see us out eating as much as we used to eat. Because I understand that something. He's letting me know that this food is toxic. And a lot of you can't hear God the way you want to hear him. It's because the food that you eat, because it's so toxic, do you know it blocks out the spiritual the spiritual discernment? Your spirit of discernment is not keen as it's supposed to be. When I stop eating all that stuff, and you know, wife be cooking, she cook all that healthy stuff. I don't want it, but I eat it. But my discernment began to get a little more quicker and a little more keen. Alright? Next word is detach. Detach means to disengage from something and remove it. And it also means a separate mission. In July, God wants you to detach from things, once again, that harm you spiritually, mentally, and naturally. You got to detach from a leader that you know is not walking upright in God. Stop right here and getting a leader of past talking about we all fall. When they sit up there preaching that gospel, they act like they the most savest thing in there. But then when they fall, they want that pity. You got to detach from people. Detach from leaders who are always talking about you got to serve them in order to get something from God. All you need to do is serve God to get something from God. Serving your leader does not mean that you're getting something from God. You have to understand that if you don't want to begin to grow, we in the almost the middle of the year. We the halfway point. And a lot of you said all that stuff at the end of the year, and you still ain't no closer than when you started. Watch this. You got to remove it. You got to detach from these relationships that not godly. I know you women, I know when he put that pipe on you, you had them legs up in the air, you ooh and you ah, I know it feel good. I know it feel good. He turning you over and hitting it front and back, I know it feel good. But is that worth missing what God has for you? That's why a lot of your lawsuits held up. That's why a lot of your blessings held up, your miracles, because you messing around with ungodly people that are allowing you to be in your principles just to be with them, and God says so much more to you. You just can't be out here giving up the ass all willy-nilly. Yeah, I said ass. You just can't be right here screwing everything because they say a scripture or they say they're going to take up for you. You mean you got to stop walking around here telling these lies just to get some free sex? I know about it. I used to do it. Ain't too long from doing it. I tell them what they want to hear to get what I want. How you a man of God? But you around here lying to these, you know. Never mind. You got to detach from that. You got to detach from the bloods and the liquor. And you can't, you a child of God. You can't sit around and listen to the dirty jokes all the time no more. Leave them dirty jokes alone. You got to detach from people who don't want you to hear the truth. You got to detach out of that pride talking about you don't like Brother Hubbard or somebody like me because we telling you how it really is. And watch this. When we finish, we ain't asking for no money. We ain't asking you to sow no seed. We ain't asking you for no donation. We just telling you the truth. Listen to how many videos people just preach. And how many at the end of, can you send a donation to such and such and such and such and such and such? Ain't no spirit of giving no more because people manipulating you spiritually, here we go, to get money out of you. You got to detach from people who are mentally abusing you and mentally using you. I was talking to a girl today that got out of ministry, that the leader was mentally abusing her, but I understood something. When you sit up on the people for so long, it takes you a while to come out from under that bewitchment. Some of y'all see people doing something so wrong, and first thing you want to holler, that's a spirit, that's that. You don't know, you forgot how hard it is to get out of some of this stuff. It's hard when you used to screwing any girl you want, to all of a sudden now you got to be faithful to one. You can't tell me it's hard. It's hard you right here laying up with these men to get your rent paid, your car note paid, and all that mess, and now you want to be faithful. It's a lot of spiritual whores in the church. Carry on. A separate mission. God wants some of you to detach and go ahead and start your ministry. But y'all around here worried about, ain't nobody going to receive me. People might not come. I need somebody to lay hands on me. Listen here, I tell y'all all the time about my testimony. I left when God told me to leave. I didn't look for no cover. My covering the Holy Spirit, because that's the one that's going to protect me, guide me, and grow me. A lot of y'all scared. Listen here, it was years before people started listening to me. I done preached where nobody didn't come. I done preached where three people didn't came. I done preached where five people didn't came. The most I seen at one time was like 300. You don't need a crowd to preach the gospel. Watch the Bible. When Paul, Peter, and all them understood they was called, they went where God told them to go. And the Bible said they either got up on some steps and they just went to preaching the gospel. But no, y'all want to charge people registration fees. You want to see how many people going to come. You get what I'm saying? You got to detach from that religious way of preaching the gospel. And the only thing that took me so long, because I was trying to fit in, but when God began to tell me, just say this, man, people came out the woodwork to hear what I got to say. Start that ministry. Don't worry about if ain't nobody coming to see you or not. As long as you do what God telling you to do, that's all that matters. The last thing, he wants to distance ourselves. He wants a distance means an amount of space between two things or people. You know who it is who holding you in that circle. So why you keep going back in that circle? At least be a square. At least be a triangle. Stop going back to it where people just gonna look over you. What I said, they acknowledge who you are, but they don't value who you are. Because if they really value who some of you was, you wouldn't be sitting on no pew still talking about preach, pastor. You'd be somewhere building your own ministry. Amount of space. You gotta get a little space from you women gotta get a little space from these men who you know when they call. That thing getting wet and them panties get wet and all of a sudden he over there and your legs are out. No! You got to delete and block that, because if you know you weak for that wood, y'all know Wood to Johnson, you know what I'm saying? You know that pressure. If you know you weak for it, stop answering the darn phone. Stop masturbating. Talking about you a child of God and you choking that chicken. You got to distance yourself from that, because your spirit got to be pure to receive what God has for you in this latter half of the month. You got to distance yourself from your family if they ain't online and what you doing. Yeah, I call my family all the now and then, but my wife tell you I'm a loner to the T. I mean, we be in the house, you know. She had a little room, the boy in his room, and I'm in the bedroom. Now, every now and then, I get up and mess with somebody, but for the most part, I'm a loner. I got to get myself out of it now that I'm married, but hey, she'll tell you I'm a loner. I don't want to be bothered with nobody. Next definition for this is a full length of a race. The Bible tells us we got to run this race to the end. Stop looking over in my lane. Try to judge and see how I do things, and then you go back and try to do it. But the fact of the matter is, if you don't have the mindset, the money, or the mentality, what you gonna do ain't gonna equal to what I'm doing. So stop looking in my lane. For that part, stop looking at everybody else like, stop trying to pattern your ministry after somebody else. Stop trying to sound like somebody else. That Don Jay-Z, I told my wife the other day, I never listened to Jay-Z in my life. I'm 47 years old. But when every radio station take over and play that new CD, he said something. He went on the rough. He said, all y'all sound the same. I don't know who is who. That's how ministry is nowadays. Listen here, I'm not promoting rap, but that Jay-Z is the most sleek, woke man I ever heard. Sleek, woke man. He sleep to things, but the things he's saying, it's for the Negro culture, or better than that, the things he's saying is for the world as a whole. I ain't never seen a radio station take one artist. In every station I turn to today, we playing this new Jay-Z. Y'all got to listen to this. Y'all got to listen to this. Now listen here. Y'all can go on with that Masonic 444 mess, but 444 add up to 12. 4 mean the world. 4 means expanding to all four corners of the world. So don't think it. Don't, so you got to realize that was a prophetic song, and if you listen to it and see what he's saying, especially when he said kill Jay-Z, y'all know Jay-Z was prideful. He started writing a song. He said he had to kill himself, which means his prideful way of thinking. Y'all got to distance yourself from y'all own thinking. In order to run this race, you got to be transparent. That darn book I'm get ready to come out, Married But Not Connected. Most of it talking about me. So if you want to know about my life this time, you're going to pay me. And I think I'm going to put $20 on this one. I say, I think. I'm going to see what the Holy Spirit says. If you want to get in my business, pay. You got to pay to know my business. I was in a marriage and wasn't connected. I did it just to do it. Wasn't trying to be on it. Wasn't trying to understand it. I had my own way of thinking. And when I say married, that means relationship too. That means when you screwing somebody and y'all married, and y'all ain't married, you married once you put that thing in them. A lot of y'all still married because you ain't being repent from that whore's lifestyle you done left. Next definition of distance is far off or remote in nature. This is time y'all gonna have to come separate yourself and hear God for your next move in Christ. It's alright to miss church two or three times. I guarantee you ain't gonna miss nothing. The only thing they gonna want is your tithe. They gonna ask you how you doing. And then they'll say, well, you gonna pay, you gonna send it, you want us to come by and get your tithe? You'll come by and get my tithe, but if I was sick and needed to go to the hospital, oh, I ain't got time right now, I'm busy. Listen here. God, watch what he said. Detox, detach, and distance. It's all about separation. In July, he wants to pull us away from the world to become more intimate with him. Listen here. I'm going to say this. I should have said it at first. You got to understand, when you hear an apostolic word, you just can't catch it and say, that's for my family, that's for me to do. This word comes from people, is for people who follow me, who I mentor, or you listen to my teaching. And if everything you listen to, or if y'all don't go back and listen to it, is leading up to what God said, those were prophetic words to prepare you for something. Now that God has prepared you, this apostolic word is to get your life in order. See, a lot of people preach a prophetic word and tell you to go get it. But it got to be an order in how you go get it. And basically what I'm seeing when God gave me this, he wants to make sure you're as spiritually pure as you can be before you receive what he got for you. Y'all be blessed. Have a good day.